In this video, we're going to talk about how we achieve effective channel reuse or maximization of the total transmitted traffic over the air using Meru single channel architecture. Now, as we've described in companion videos, the core principle of Meru is to be able to do layered channels. So wherein, in the extreme case, every megahertz is available everywhere. So because Meru has the ability to deploy APs on a single channel, in other words, cover an entire region with a single channel, we have the ability to layer channels one on top of the other. Unlike, let's say, a microcell architecture where you need multiple channels even to provide one layer of coverage. So interestingly, doing single channel coverage allows you to do multi-layer coverage, while requiring multiple channels can only effectively give you one layer of coverage in any area. So now, there is a legitimate question that might come in your mind, which is, if all the access points are on a single channel, how do we do channel reuse? Is it the case that there's only one device that can communicate at any time? And the answer to that, of course, is no. So what I'd like to do in this video is describe the mechanism that we apply and the algorithms that we apply in order to maximize channel reuse. So let me draw a picture here and try to explain this concept. So you have some coverage region. You have, let's say, multiple access points. And I'm going to describe it in the context of a single channel architecture. So by design, all of these access points are on the same channel. They advertise the same BSS ID. And therefore, from a client perspective, there's just one single network that it sees. Client sees only one BSS ID, and that is the virtual port concept that we already introduced in a companion video. The question here is, assuming coverage as follows, and obviously I'm drawing these as circles for simplicity, in a real world environment, these are not required to be circles. As a matter of fact, with Meru, we don't care what they are. Right? So let's assume this is the coverage. And notice from the client perspective, you don't see these cell boundaries, right? Because they all advertise the same BSS ID. We've already talked about that. The question that we have in this video that we seek to answer is, how many simultaneous transmissions can happen given this particular coverage map? And you can sort of just look at this and reason for yourself that this access point, this one, and this one can communicate at the same time. Right? So obviously, it's not a quote-unquote Big Mac wherein we are trying to centralize the medium access protocol or centralize the contention domain. Access points that don't interfere with each other, of course, can transmit at the same time. But you could do a lot better. Even access points that interfere with each other, in fact, can transmit at the same time. And that's where a lot of our core IP and intelligence comes in. So let me describe to you, at least at a high level, what the concept is, and then see if we can get into some more details. So let's just expand on this area, right? So now you have two access points. And roughly speaking, even though these are the coverage areas, let's assume that these two APs hear each other. Now let's describe the overall concept. If it turns out that you have two stations very close to their respective access points, notice that even though these access points and stations can hear each other, in fact, these two communications can go on simultaneously. Why is that? That's because the signal, let's look at it from the station's perspective, even if both of these access points are communicating at the same time, the signal from AP1 is strong enough that the client can receive it over the signal from AP2. Because one is near, the other is far. So think of this as what happens, let's say, in a crowded area or in a party or a bar, right? So where you can talk to the person next to you, even though you can actually hear communication from people further away. Now, conversely, if it turns out that AP1 is trying to talk to station one, this station here, while AP2 is trying to talk to this station here, that will cause a collision. So the point we are making is, if it turns out that the signal-to-noise ratio from the intended receiver or the intended transmitter is sufficiently high that it can overcome the noise caused by transmitters far enough away, then in fact parallel conversations can happen. And the trick here is to figure out which are these parallel conversations that can happen simultaneously without causing the collision of transmissions like this. And that's where all our poor IP comes in.